Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create and configure Syncfusion Angular Calendar using the Angular CLI command. I'm going to show you how to add the calendar component to an app using the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Calendars package. Angular Calendar is a rich UI component used to display dates and days of the week. It provides month, year, and decade views to quickly navigate to the desired date. It supports minimum, maximum, and disabled dates to restrict date selection. I will show you how to configure a few of its basic features, like setting specific date range values to the calendar, multidate selection, and navigation between different calendar views such as a month, year, and decade. Let me show you the application creation process. First, I create my app using the Angular CLI command. I use VS Code as the editor and show the output in Chrome browser. In command prompt, I need to install the npm install global angular CLI command. Then I create a new Angular project using the ng new command and provide the app name, my Angular project. I navigate to the desired location and install the calendar package using the command ng add at Syncfusion EJ2 Angular calendars. Now, I open the project in VS Code. To start using the calendar component, navigate to the App Module page and import the calendar module from the Syncfusion EJ2 Angular Calendars package and register it in the imports array of the ng module. After that, I import the material theme styles to the style.css file to apply styles to the calendar component. Next, I need to register the Syncfusion license key. Open the main TypeScript file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, register the Angular trial license. From 2022 Volume 1 release, license key is mandatory in Angular projects to avoid license warning. In app.component.html file, replace the default code snippets with Angular calendar using the EJS calendar tag. I will run this project using the command ng-serve. As you can see, the output displays the calendar component with today's date highlighted. You can also navigate between the calendar, dates, months, and years. Next, I will show you how to select a specific date value so that the calendar highlights the date on initial load. Dates can be specified using the value property. Within the app component class, I define a variable date value of the date type and assign a value to it. I then assign this variable to the value property of the calendar. As you can see, the specified date value is selected on the calendar. When today button is clicked, it shows the current date. Now, let me show you how to restrict the date value selection within a specified range by defining the min and max properties. Within the app component class, I declare a variable minDate of the date type and set a start date value. Similarly, I define another variable maxDate and set it as the end date value. Then, I assign these values to the corresponding min and max properties. Check now, I cannot select the date values that is beyond the specified min and max date range. By default, you can select a single date. You can select multiple dates in a calendar by adding the isMultiSelection property and setting its value to true. As you can see, I've selected multiple date values. Finally, I will show you how to change and navigate between different views of the calendar. There are three types of views: month, year, and decade, and month is the default view. To change the view to decade, I add the start property and set its value to decade. Now the calendar displays the years in a decade. When I click a specific year, it shows the list of months in a year, and on clicking the month again, it shows the days of the selected month. This is the drill-down action of calendar view navigation from decade to month view. Using start and depth properties, I can limit the drill-down and drill-up actions of the calendar while navigating through the views. Now, I will show you how to control the drill-up action of calendar view navigation using the depth property. So, let me include the depth property and set its value to year. Note that the depth value should always be lesser than the start value. As you can see, when I select a year from the calendar, it shows months in a year, and on clicking a month, it does not show the days of that month. This shows how easily you can define the features of the Angular calendar using its simple built-in APIs. In this video, I have shown you how to create and configure the Syncfusion Angular Calendar component using the Angular CLI command and a few of its basic features. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will get you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.